Welcome. In this video, we're going to show you how to register for an Illinois 4-H event using the ZSuite enrollment system. Illinois 4-H uses ZSuite to track all of our family's experiences in the 4-H program, including clubs, events, workshops, camps, and more. You need to create a free ZSuite account at 4-H.zsuite.org for your family in order to participate and register for these events. Accounts are free and they're very easy to set up. If you don't already have a ZSuite account, you can go to go.illinois.edu/4-H online enrollment to be taken to a tutorial page on how to set up an account. There's a video and detailed instructions on how you create a family account and then add members to your household. Each member you want to enroll in an event needs to have their own profile underneath your family account. So once you have an account, you're going to go back to 4-H.zsuite.org and you're going to put in your information so you can log in. So you're going to put in your email address and your password and then hit this orange login button. Then you'll be taken to this Choose Profile page. This page should have a profile for every adult and youth member in your family who might be registering for an event. So this family has two adults and two youth with profiles. When you're going in to register for an event, you always do that from your primary profile. So the primary profile is where you do all the management over event registrations and other things that affect the whole family. So it's always, the primary profile is always on the left. It has a pink background and it says primary under it. So you're going to go ahead and choose this profile. When you do that, you're going to be asked for an account PIN. So whatever PIN you set when you signed up, you're going to go ahead and add that to the menu. All right. So next, we're going to be taken to our household dashboard. And this is what you get every time you log into ZSuite. What you first want to check on this household platform and dashboard is that everyone that you want to register for an event is already listed under your household member section and is listed as active. You won't be able to register people for events that aren't active. So active status means if you're in a club, you've enrolled in a club, paid, and been approved, or if you've gone in to create an account, you've selected, I'm not a club member. And if you've done that, you'll be marked as active status. So make sure the people you want to enroll in the event are appearing here and that they are active. If they're not appearing, you can add another household member using this green plus household member button. So to get to events, you really have two options. You can browse events on the calendar by clicking on it and then kind of clicking on individual events that are on the calendar. Or you can go to the events page. And this is the page you can most easily register for. So we recommend you start here. So it's in your menu a couple entries down under events. So at the top of this page, you have a search bar. You can search by date, you can filter by different words, and you can search for events either at the county or state level. So if this gets very busy, feel free to use the search boxes to narrow your results. You'll see that some events are informational in nature. This one, for example, just gives me information that this is part of National 4-H Week. And this one gives information on event and then has a link to learn more and register on a different website. But there are events that you can register for in the system. And those events will have a pink register now button underneath them. So you can take a look and say like, oh, is this an event I'd be interested in participating in? You can check out all the information you need, see if there's a fee involved. This one has a $5 fee, where it's located, what the min and max age to attend are, and who the contact information is, and how many people or seats are left for this event. So if you're interested in attending an event, all you have to do to register is click on the pink register now button. That'll take you to an event registration screen that'll pre-populate the top with any members of your household that qualify for that event. So in this instance, this was an event for youth ages 5 to 18. So only my youth family members showed up here as people who could register. So if I want to register one of these kids for the event, I just click the blue register button next to their name. Then I'll be taken to the registration questions page. Any question that has an asterisk is required, and you can leave the other questions blank. So this one, I need to answer this question about pumpkin size. So I'm going to pick a medium-sized pumpkin. I don't have any dietary restrictions or accommodations, so I'm going to leave those fields blank. This does ask me to read over and complete the following releases. It looks like I've already completed these releases when I enrolled in 4-H. So I can just go ahead and choose to either submit my registration if that's the only kid I'd like to enroll, or I can save and register another participant. I'd like to register my brother as well. So I'm going to go ahead and hit save and register another participant. So next I'm going to click on Clint and I'm going to hit register. I'll get the same registration screens. Say this time I would like a large pumpkin and I might write a dietary restriction on here, like that this youth is gluten-free. And again, I'm going to see just that I have signed these release forms, and then I'm going ahead and I'm going to submit the registration because I'm done registering all the kids in my family. If I had more kids to register, I'd go ahead and hit save and register another participant. I'm going to hit submit registration. It's going to ask me to confirm that I want to submit these registrations, and I'm going to say yes. Then this should load and give me a checkout cart screen. Some events will have no fee, so you'll just submit the registration and be done with it. If the event does have a fee, you'll get a cart screen. It'll break down the fee by person and give you a total. You'll usually have a credit card button down here to say pay by credit card. This one doesn't have online payments available at the moment. So it tells you to pay by check or cash at your office. But you could pay by credit card, or you can hit this submit and pay later in person if you choose to pay by check at a later date. So I'm going to hit that. Once I do that, these youth are registered, but they are pending payment. So technically, you're not allowed to come to the event until you pay. So you should follow staff directions. They'll send you an email once you register, and you can follow the directions of that email on where to send your check or where to drop your check off. And once that check is received, your registration's official and you'll be ready to attend that event. So the nice thing is once you're under, you're logged in, you can go back to the events page and you can scroll through and you will see that your kids are already enrolled in this event when you're kind of going through. And you can go in and kind of make edits or changes by hitting this pencil button. So that's how you register for an event in ZSuite. If we go back to our dashboard, we can go ahead and log in under these youth and see the events that they've signed up for. So I have this list and I have Abigail signed up for this pumpkin carving contest. And if I go look at Clint and I open his account, I can click on events and I can see that he's also signed up. So this is a place for you to check all the events that you've signed up for when they're taking place. Then you can go back, you can go to the events tab to go back and browse and learn more about those events you've signed up for. Thanks for watching this video. Reach out to your county staff as you have questions.